Simona was a lady who was 40 years old, and she was working for a very prestigious company. She had been working for that company for a good number of years, and one day she decided to talk to one of her friends about how she was feeling, and she expressed the feelings of being now ready for a new challenge in her company. She thought that she was ready to be given more responsibilities and to be given a promotion. Well, this friend, unfortunately, gave her a very dangerous and bad advice. Her friend said, "Well, let's go to visit someone who can read your cards and who can tell you what is going to happen in your life." And Simona followed her advice, since she was trusting in her friend. So she went, and this person who was reading the cards for Simona told her that she was going to be very successful. She was going to be given the promotion that she wanted to get. And the only thing that she has to do is to give her soul to the devil. She was Catholic, and she really didn't believe much in the devil. So she thought, well, it's just like saying some empty words. It's like a game. Who cares? But if I can get my promotion just by saying that, I will do it. And she did. And again, she saw that it was something simple, something that was not going to have any effect in her life. But she was going to get the promotion. 6 months later, she received a phone call when she was told that she was being promoted. So she went from being just a simple employee to be someone who was in charge of one of the departments of the company. And she was making 3 times as much as she was doing before. And she was very happy. That's what she was looking for. She got a new car, a new house, new friends, and life was very successful. Just like the gentleman who read the cards to her had mentioned to her. So everything was fine, and she was living a great life according to her eyes for a year. And then, after a year, the devil came to claim his possession. So he started to manifest in the life of Simona. And Simona wasn't expecting that. She didn't even believe that the devil really existed. And what started to happen to her was something strange. She would be working in her office, and then suddenly she would be so furious and so angry. But she didn't know why. And she wanted to do something and she couldn't control herself. That was happening to her so many times. She thought that probably she was going under a lot of stress. That's probably why she was feeling so angry and disappointed. It was something inside of her. But the thing became worse when Simona's secretary would come into her office to ask her for something or something that have to be done. Simona will feel in her heart and will be hearing something inside of her saying, "Kill her, kill her, you have to kill her." So she started to be so worried about how come that I hear this voice telling me to kill my secretary. She's such a great girl, she's doing a good job, why am I going to kill her? Well, everything was becoming so strong in her heart to the point that she needed to control herself. And to control herself, she needed to go into the bathroom and lock herself in for a good 5 minutes in order to be able to calm down and to relax. The situation was becoming worse and worse. She just didn't want to kill her secretary, but to kill anyone that she was having a conversation with. Anyone would be talking to her about anything, and then she would feel this in her heart, kill this person, kill this person. It was so much hatred coming from her heart toward the person. So she would go into the bathroom, and she would be hitting the walls of the bathroom. She would be bleeding, coming out, and with bruises. And people started to notice it. So now she was concerned because she was harming herself. And it is at that time when she decided to visit an exorcist. And she was privileged to be able to talk to Father Amorth, the official exorcist from the Diocese of Rome. And Father Amorth started to talk to her to see if he can understand where the root of the problem was. Where was it coming from? What did you do in your life? What are you doing now? So Simona told him the whole story. So Father was able to understand that it was from that point when she visited the person who was reading her cards, and when she said that she was willing to give her soul to the devil, that the devil started to claim possession of her soul. So he started the process of exorcism, and because she deliberately and freely chose to give her soul to the devil, that is more difficult to free her from this situation. So it was a long process of prayers of liberation and exorcisms being performed to Simona. And one day, Simona came to talk to Father Amorth and said, "Father, you're not going to believe this. I was called by the president of the company, and he told me that I can become the vice president of the company. This is the greatest thing that I can receive. It's a great opportunity. And I am willing, and I think I'm prepared and intelligent to be able to do that." And Father said, "Simona, this is it. This is the time for you to decide. That promotion is not coming from the Lord. This is coming from the devil. He is the one who is working on this case. And now the fight has been declared. The devil is trying to prove that you are more into the money and the success of this world than into the Lord and the things that belong to Christ. This is the time for you to decide." Simona has been in the process of exorcism, and she was then reintroduced to a prayerful life. She was praying the Holy Rosary daily, and Father Amorth taught her a beautiful prayer from the Blessed Virgin Mary. We had here actually the image of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Tomorrow, July 16th, we celebrate the feast of Our Lady Mount Carmel. But some of the words that Our Lady pronounced that are attributed to her are something that Father Amorth taught Simona. You can say, "O Holy Mary, conceived without original sin, have mercy on me." So she was saying that over and over, as well as praying the Holy Rosary and participated in the sacraments. "This is the time," Father Amorth told Simona, "this is the time for you to decide. You can break the bonds that you have with the devil and come closer to the Lord, or the situation will be worse for you. You will be very successful at the beginning, but the devil can promise you many things, but he's not going to keep it up for you. He's not willing. He just simply wants you to be into it, and once you are into it, he will abandon you and you will be condemned. This is the time for you to decide. You have to say no to that position. And Simona said, yes, Father, but they told me that they were going to fire the vice president and they are willing to give me that position. If I don't take it, someone else is going to take it. So instead of just letting that go, I just can take it. So, well, this is your decision. My suggestion is, let it go. Don't take it. This is coming from the devil. Fortunately, Simona followed the advice of the exorcist, and she said no. 6 months later, she was fired from the company, and she lost her job. And with that, she didn't have the money to afford paying the house that she had, the car, and she went back to her old friends, to her old life. And even though she was without work, without a job, she was still feeling something in her heart, some hatred. And Father Abbott was still working and doing exorcisms to her. Without money, without a job, for 2 years. It was very stressful, it was very difficult for her to go through. But after 2 years later, Simona was talking to one of her friends, and then she felt this thing in her heart again of so much hatred. And she left the room where she was talking to her friend, and she wanted to cry outside so loud. And when she cried, when she was screaming so loud, she felt that the devil left her body. And she was finally feeling again herself, free. So it was a long process for her, and it took so much from her. And it shows how it is important that the things that we do and the words that we say, they're always connected to who we are, to our soul, and to the relationship with our Lord. And I wanted to mention this case to you today because we have been talking about the different things that happen in our spiritual life. And we have been talking lately about the different attacks that the devil can do to us. We mentioned that the first one is temptation, which is an unhealthy curiosity that the devil puts in our sides, in our lives. Temptations come to everyone. All of us experience the temptation of the devil. His goal is to take us away from the Lord. He is condemned. He doesn't want to be condemned alone. He wants us to be condemned with him. But the Lord wants us to be saved. So the first attack from the devil is temptation. The second we mentioned last weekend is the infestation. When an object or a place, a house, can be dedicated to the devil, and the devil can use it to start working in a more stronger way to someone. And today, the other strategy, the other attack that the devil uses is vexation. And a good example of how vexation is found in Holy Scripture, in the life of Job. Vexation is when the devil attacks the person, but he attacks what is surrounding the person. His friends, his possessions, his health. And that's why Job is a good example of vexation in Holy Scripture. Notice how Job, being a just man, he loses his possessions, his children. He got sick to the point that his friends felt sorry to see him, how sick he was. He was so sick that he even had worms in his in his skin. How, that's how pitiful he was. Because the devil wanted to make sure that he wanted to be discouraged and to be away from the Lord. And when something like that happened, there are usually two reactions. One is bad and another, and the other one is good. One reaction to it is that the one that is bad is that people then feel so bad that they are losing their possessions and their relatives and close friends and people, members of their own homes, even their health, that they were going to curse the Lord. And they will be so mad and angry at the Lord. And therefore, they will be separated from the Lord. That's something bad that we don't want to do. The other one is the good one, when people realize that it's happening, and that it is happening because of the influence of the devil, that they come closer to Christ. They know that they need God even more. They know that in God they find their refuge and protection. That's what we have to do. When we experience difficulties, when we are sick, when we know that we are weak, that's when we have to come closer to the Lord. St. Paul says that in a beautiful way, when I am weak, then I am strong. When we know that the devil is attacking us in one way or another, so we realize how weak we are, that's when we have to come to the Lord even more. And we will know that then we are strong. May the Lord help us to know that only in Jesus Christ we find salvation and we find the love that we are looking for. In Him we find the refuge and the graces to fight against the work and the attacks of the devil. Jesus Christ is stronger than the devil. That's why we worship our Lord Jesus Christ forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.